Leaving his humble upbringing in Beverly Hills and a Stanford education, Sam Simon journeyed all the way to the bright lights of Reseda with a dream. A dream to bring joy and laughter to the world through the magic of television. At age 23, Sam struck it big, becoming one of the youngest showrunners in Hollywood history, bringing us Taxi, Cheers, Best of the West, The Tracy Ullman Show, Barney Miller, It's Gary Shandling Show, The George Carlin Show, The Drew Carey Show, and of course, The Simpsons. The Simpsons alone has brought home 10 Primetime Emmy Awards, and so far, Sam's career has garnered him 22 Emmy nominations with 11 wins and one Peabody. Sam Simon, the television superpower, the comedic visionary, citizen of Earth, but most importantly,
Sam has famously said on Twitter that he's just a kid from Beverly Hills who got lucky, but he's a whole lot more than that. Sam is involved with many animal groups, including us at Mercy for Animals, and the work that we're able to do because of his support is just invaluable. And that's not even including his own foundation, which feeds hundreds of families every week in Los Angeles, vegan meals.
The Sam Simon Foundation runs the grandest dog shelter in the country, a 5-star, 6-acre spread in Malibu.
We rescue dogs and we train them to be service dogs, which helps people with disabilities.
This is a guy who does the heavy lifting that makes a difference and actually is close to eradicating whaling in the case of Sea Shepherd and putting a big dent in the cruelty to a lot of animals worldwide.
Sam has a way of conveying information about what happens to animals in a way that's very disarming, and he is truthful and he never shies away from the hard facts, but he delivers them in a way that's absorbable for people.
He has a charm and a humor and a magic about communicating that makes you aware. I was already a vegetarian, and I was just listening on the headphones while I was waiting to be a guest on Sam's show, and just hearing about the treatment of some of the animals in factory farms made me ask myself the question, how come you drew the line at vegetarian?
You know, these are issues that are really hot topics and require people of means and people of great patience to put long-term energy into these causes that take time to take effect.
He got word through PETA that there were these bears that were being horribly mistreated in this terrible roadside zoo and being just basically tortured. And Sam secretly bought all of these bears and released them to an animal sanctuary. And as they're pulling the one bear off the truck, Sam went in to say hello to it, and he leaned in and he said, he goes, "Everything is gonna be okay now."
Sam Simon is the one to shine the light and say, hey, this is what is possible, folks. We can make a difference. We can make change today and now. And no matter who you are, no matter where you're from, your voice is important. Your voice needs to be heard. It's time to stand up and make a change. And that's what Sam Simon's done for me. So, Sam, I thank you personally from the bottom of my heart. I love you.
To the most compassionate fella I know, Sam Simon, you're incredible. Jennifer and I are very happy to have you in our lives, and you're awesome.
And we're very, very, very proud of you. Congratulations, Sam.
You, sir, are an inspiration to me personally and to so many of us who care about animals. And you've brought to that cause. And frankly, it's an honor to know someone who has been in the vanguard and so very active. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Sam. From me, Vegan Ari, and everyone at Mercy for Animals. We love you.